We live, y'all. We live.
Latinos and Native Americans, and those of you of confusion and faith that are scattered abroad. Okay, this is GMS Miami, GMS Des Moines, Iowa, and GMS South. Some beautiful dignities in town. Okay, you better want to introduce yourself.
Kanye, I'm the brother you call.
Brother Josiah.
Brother Kawarian.
Brother Josiah.
Okay, you know, always a beautiful thing, dignities in town, you know. Nothing playing through the spirit, the open form, and you know, we're going to bring it out.
This is Ezekiel chapter 3 in verse 17. It says, Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore hear the word at my mouth and give them warning from me. Okay, so that's right, man. So the Lord has set up watchmen, all right, to give the people warning from the Heavenly Father what's to come to pass, man. That's what a prophet is. A prophet tells you what's going to happen before it's happening, all right? Now, this isn't, when we go out on the highways and byways, we don't speak these things out of our own minds, our own imaginations, what we just think is going to happen. We just think World War III is going to happen. We just think martial law is going to happen. No, these are things that are warnings from the Heavenly Father, and we find these throughout the scriptures, man. Alright, so it says, Son of man, I made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore hear the word at my mouth, and give them warning from me. When I say unto the wicked, Thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way, to save his life, the same wicked man shall die in his iniquity. But his blood will I require at thine hand. Hey, so that's right, man. So, as the scripture says, man, woe unto us if we preach not the gospel. All right, so the Lord has given us this glorious gospel, the eyes to see these things, to be able to break down these prophecies, and therefore we have a duty. We have an unction. So what? To be watchmen, to warn the people. So those that are out there that have that the ability to break down these scriptures correctly and directly, and they're not doing so, aren't warning the wicked from their wicked way, the blood is going to be upon their hands, man. All right?
I want to back you up too, though.
Come. It says, yet if thou warn the wicked, and he turn not from his wickedness, nor from his wicked way, he shall die in his iniquity, but thou hast delivered thy soul. So that's right. If you warn the people, all right, it doesn't matter whether they take heed or not, man, whether they heed or forbear. As long as you did what you were given the duty to do, by Yahweh Hashem Yahrashad, man. That blood is going to be upon their head, upon their own heads, man. Because you did your job, you know. So that's what we're doing, man. We're cleaning the blood off of our hands, man. Because contrary to popular belief, the Lord is about to bring mass death and destruction upon the planet Earth, man.
Right.
All right? A lot of people are going to die. A lot of children, a lot of you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans are going to die of grievous deaths because you have not chosen to repent from your wickedness, man, for lack of better terms.
What it boils down to is somebody has to care. Somebody has to care about the nation of Israel. Okay, the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. And that's the men that you see on the highways and hedges, warning you that the Heavenly Father is about to unleash his wrath.
That's right.
You know? And like your brother was bringing out, and us doing that, we get the blood off our hands. You know, the scriptures say we've all fallen short of the glory, you know. But somebody has to care, and we care, you know. But whether you hear for bread, that's on you.
This is Isaiah 62:6. It says, I have set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem, which shall never hold their peace day nor night. Ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silent. All right, so the Lord has set up watchmen, man, and it says, and we ain't going to keep silent, man. We're not going to hold our peace. until we actually have peace, man. We're going to keep prophesying the downfall of this wicked-ass kingdom until it come down, man, until the Lord come and give us peace here on earth, man.
That's right.
You know?
I got this precept right here because, like the scripture, the brother said, whether they fear, whether they forbear. There's a judgment if you don't forbear, or if you forbear, if you don't take heed, if you don't listen to the words of the prophets, which is where the prophets get their word from, we all watch and y'all shot. Scripture said, he set us, set us up as watchmen. He's speaking his word, man. This is Mark chapter 6 and verse 10. It says, and he said unto them, in what place soever ye enter into a house, there abide to ye apart from that place. And whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear you, when ye depart thence, shake off the dust under your feet for a testimony against them. Verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment for that city. So all you people that are not listening, not taking heed to the prophets on the highways and byways, you're going to have the death of Sodom and Gomorrah, worse than Sodom and Gomorrah, man. Because Sodom and Gomorrah just rained fire and brimstone. Wasn't no damn martial law in Sodom and Gomorrah. Wasn't no famine. Wasn't no pestilence. Wasn't no race riots in Sodom and Gomorrah. It was just the fire and brimstone. But here in America, it's going to be all that, including the fire and brimstone, man. The Lord said that he would put the same plagues upon this earth because why? The wickedness has exceedingly polluted the whole earth, man. This place got to go down. And we see that the plagues are coming because look at the wickedness, man. The wickedness is constantly increasing day by day. Constantly, Esau is fucking breaking records every day, man. All right, got trannies walking around, gender neutrality, non-binary genders. All right, all this shit is being promoted and pushed out into the mass media, and that is causing a heavy wicked vibration to spread upon the face of the earth, man.
This is Jeremiah 29:18, and I will persecute them with the sword, with the famine, and with the pestilence. And I will deliver them to be removed to all kingdoms of the earth to be a curse and an astonishment and a hissing and a reproach among all the nations whither I have driven them. All right, so that's what's happening to the two-thirds, man. Ultimately, that's what all happened to Israel. But he's going to persecute the two-thirds in these last days with famine, pestilence, all the plagues of Egypt, plus more is coming into Babylon known as America. All right, the next scripture is talking about the many sin. It says, because they have not hearkened to my words, saith Yahweh, which I have sent unto them by my servants the prophets, rising up early and sending them. But ye would not hear, saith the Lord. All right, so they don't listen, man. They don't listen to the men of the Lord on the highways and the hedges prophesying the words of the Heavenly Father. You know, like Yahweh said, it is not my words I speak, but my Father which speaketh in you. All right, so it's Yahweh that's speaking within us to give us these words to prophesy. But the two-thirds don't listen. The heathens don't listen. All right? The Heavenly Father has blinded them from seeing the truth, from blinded them from seeing the words that are in this book, because the Lamb only opened the book for the one-third, the elect of the nation of Israel. All right?
Book of Jeremiah, chapter 6, verse 17. Also, I set watchmen over you, saying, hearken to the sound of the trumpet. But they said, we will not hearken. Right, we're out here sounding the alarm, man. All right, blowing that trumpet. All right, telling our people to hearken. But once, like the brother said, like, you've been bringing all these precepts. All right, we know two-thirds are not going to listen, man. They're not going to hear the words of Yahweh Shema Shah. All right?
Can I get this quick precept?
Yeah.
This is Joel 2:1. It says, blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble.
Right.
For the day of the Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai cometh, for it is not at hand.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. That's what we're doing. We're blowing the trumpet, all right? And hey, we're in fear because we see what's about to come, and that's why we be in this truth, man. We stay in this truth, man. All right? Because the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, man. All right? So, but a majority of people are not scared, man. They're out there and they're following party and bullshit, man. Especially down here in Miami. Alright? So that's what we're doing. Sound the alarm, sound the trumpet, but they're not going to hear. Alright, let me continue on. Verse 18. Therefore hear, ye nations, and know, O congregation, what is among them. Verse 19. Hear, O earth, behold, I will bring evil upon this people, even the fruit of their thoughts, because they have not hearkened unto my words, nor to my law, but rejected.
And that's really what it is, man. That's all people, man. To the teeth. They reject the Lord Yahabashi Yahshai. They don't want to harken to Yahabashi Yahshai. You see the prophets constantly out there, okay, blowing the trumpet, all right? Warning our people, getting the blood up their hands, but the majority of people still not be here. So that's why the Lord is going to bring that evil upon you, man.
And just for example, though, when we was in Miami on this trip, who was that you said y'all saw? Adrian. You know what I'm saying? The brother was telling him, hey, don't you know you're an Israelite? You know what I'm saying? All his main concern was just being in Miami, man. And being in folly, you know, living in folly, man. He don't have no cares in the world, man. Because he don't realize the destruction that's about to come to this place, man. But the name of the Lord is constantly, hey, giving it to y'all, man. Raw and uncut, telling you the prophecies that's coming to pass, and y'all don't want to hearken, man. So, hey, y'all can get death and destruction coming to you, man.
To be honest, man, Miami is played out, bro. America is played out. Business is played out. That's why even Ron and all these people, they unhappy, bro. But you unhappy as fuck, man. That is the truth. Just ain't for you. You want to dwell in your wickedness. You gonna die in your wickedness, man.
That's right. Proverbs 13, and it says in verse 13, whoso despises the word shall be destroyed, but he that feareth the commandment shall be rewarded. Alright, so if you despise the word of the Heavenly Father that he's speaking by the mouth of the servant of the prophets, you're going to be destroyed by the Heavenly Father.
That's right.
Because it's the word of the Heavenly Father that is being spoken through men. Alright, the Most High is righteous and wise and just in all he does, man. And our people reject that, man. They want to make their own gods. They want to fall out the imagination of their own hearts, man. Alright, not knowing that the Most High is faithful in mercy and in judgment, man.
That's right.
Okay? And that's why when the judgment comes, it's going to come hard and fast. And unlike anything ever, man, because Most High has been very long-suffering to our people, man.
That's right.
This is the perfect precept, and that was the spirit how that came out. This is 2 Ezra chapter 7 and verse 20. It says, for there shall be many that perish in this life because they despise the law of Yahweh that is set before them. So you tell them who they are, and they despise it. You tell them you're supposed to be living by this Bible, and they despise it. You tell them that Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai is our power, that you're an Israelite, that you're not a nigga, that you're not a spit, all right? And they still despise it, man. So what's going to be the punishment for that? Death and destruction, man. Woe unto you. All right, I'll read again. This is 2 Ezra 7:20. It says, for there be many that perish in this life. There's going to be a lot of people that die. Why? Because they despise the law of Yahweh that is set before them. For Yahweh have given strict commandment to such as came what they should do to live. Yeah, so the Lord told us the breakdown, man. He gave us the breakdown like Lot, all right? He told Lot. He sent the angels to Lot and said, you got to get up out of here. Hearken unto my angels and you can live. Same with us, man. Hearken unto the prophets and we can live, man. Take heed unto the word of Yahweh, Shem Yahshua. You can make it about this hellhole. You can escape the famine, the fire and brimstone, all the hell that's coming to this place. We're
going to
escape it by the Lord's word, man.
Uh-huh. And I say this, and it's been the same narrative. Every captivity.
Yeah.
Every time, return unto me. So the judgment the Heavenly Father is about to unleash on you people is warranted, man.
That's right.
And then the scriptures still say that you haven't received what, you know, roughly paraphrasing, the judgment that Israel is supposed to receive, you haven't received. Because that's the Most High, yet again, showing his mercy, man.
Less than what our iniquities deserve.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So really, the hell that we caught, man, it's really nothing to what we're supposed to have, man. What the scripture says, we're all worthy of the punishment. Like, we're all worthy to be sitting, swimming in that lake of fire, man. But what the Lord is having mercy upon Israel by sending the prophets out on the highways and byways so that they have an opportunity to repent from their iniquities, man. You know what I'm saying? But what? Jake isn't going to repent. And it's ultimately through the Spirit of the Lord, Spirit of Yahweh, Shem Yahweh Shai, blinding them that they may be damned. And the Most High can do that. Why? Because he's the Most High, man. This is his movie, man. People got a problem with the Most High being the Most High, man.
That's right.
You know, that he can do what he wants, you know?
That's right.
That's exactly right, man. You know?
Quick precept for that. Yeah. Psalms chapter 115, verse 1. Not unto us, O Yahweh, not unto us, but unto thy name give glory. For thy mercy and for thy truth's sake, wherefore should the heathen say, where is now their power? But our power is in the heavens. He has done whatsoever he pleased. So, yeah, the Lord do what he pleased, man. And it pleases him to wake up his men, really. It pleases him to have his men go out on the streets and wake up the nation of Israel. Yeah, two-thirds won't get it, man. They just won't get it. Real quick, another one. Ezekiel chapter 33, verse 1. Say unto them, as I live, says the Lord of power, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from his way and live. Turn ye from your evil ways, for why will you die, O house of Israel? And that's what we say out in the streets. Why will you die? The Lord is offering salvation for his people. He actually wants the Lord. Israel is the apple of the Lord's eye, man. But really, it's the Israel of the Most High. Because two-thirds, they got to die on this side. And as the scriptures say, they shall all be saved anyways. They shall come back in the kingdom anyway. But now, since they don't want to come back to the Heavenly Father, they got to get put to death, man.
Right. And just to back you up, the scripture says in the book of the 12th chapter, it says that it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom of the Most High, man.
That's right.
All right, man, it's not. You think the Lord delights in seeing our people being homosexual, sodomites out here, man? Our women out here twerking, man? The Lord isn't delighted in that, man. Wouldn't you delight in your child being obedient instead of whipping his ass every day he comes home from school, you know? Because he's doing wickedness? Nah, man. It's the same thing with the Most High, man. He wants to bring in the kingdom, man. But what we have to learn our lesson, we have to sincerely repent and turn from our iniquities, man.
Just an example. Us as when we was kids, man, our parents used to be like, hey, this gonna hurt me as much as it hurts you. You know what I'm saying? After you before they start whooping your ass. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's the same thing. So the Most High, it hurts him, man. You know? But hey, but that's why, hey, we're gonna go through this. This is our last captivity. But he made a way so that he can put the laws in our inward parts so we ain't got to go off no more. We ain't got to worry about getting punished and getting our ass whooped no more, man.
Mm-hmm.
That's right, you
know? It goes to show that the Lord don't really want to have his wrath upon Israel no more. That's why he's going to make it straight. It's one good time, so we don't have to have wrath on Israel, man.
Hey. He said, shall you be stricken anymore? You know, more and more, man. The Lord keeps fucking this up. Just read the book of Judges, man. Captivity after captivity after captivity. Our people would go off and cry to the Most High. Then they go off again, cry to the Most High. The Lord's tired and done with that, man. He's tired and done with that. Now he's going to skip. He's not going to do it like ancient Egypt, man, where he deliver all of us so he can hear you niggas talking shit again, man. Fuck all that, man. He's going to do away with you right now. Let's see. He's already hearing you murmuring, man. You're not murmuring against us. You're murmuring against the Most High. We're just the messengers. We're just the prophets. Like the brothers read in the first scripture, man. We're the watchmen that was set up, warning you. I'm telling you that you're going to die, that the enemy is coming, and you pissed off at me. Nigga, I'm trying to save your life. It says open rebuke is better than secret love. So when we go on the highways and byways, we're not out there to condemn everybody. We out there looking for the whole four leg. But it just so happens that majority of the people is going to be condemned. Going back to that scripture I read, it said what? That many there be that perish. Man, these niggas, it's not going to click until niggas start dropping dead, man. Like brothers was going into, when these black bitches start dropping dead, man, these little ass nigga kids start dropping dead, that's when Jake is going to be serious, man.
Right.
Same with the damn Northern Kingdom. They completely bug the fuck out of their mind, but just wait till they literally start getting touched, man. Just wait till their children start dropping dead. Just wait till they hit with a big ass pestilence. That's when you're going to get right. And guess what? It's going to be too late, man. Scripture saying Hosea that in their affliction, they will seek me early, man. You're not going to find it, though, man. All right? Because this is how you get the repentance right here. We pushing the same message that Yahweh Shah was pushing, man. Repent for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So the only way to get into the kingdom is to repent. Luke 13:3 says, unless you repent, you shall all likewise perish, man. So either you repent or you die. But if you do repent, you get to enter into the kingdom, man.
And speak a part of our, this trial, you know, of what we've been through as a nation, and seeing how far gone our people are. You know, it's to the point now where not only do they not take heed to warning, but they mock it. Like you said, brother, we're telling you, look, Heavenly Father about to come and kill many. And you mock us for going. But that shows you how far gone as a nation our people are. So somebody got to stand up and be ambassadors, you know, for our kingdom, for our nation.
That's it.
And that's us, you know, and we don't care. That's what the scriptures say, be not, you know, incredulity, let not the incredulity of trouble. No, man, because we're standing up for our nation, man. All that other shit, that's minuscule, man. We got bigger fish to fry, man.
And that's the reason why the Lord's making these prophecies come out faster and faster, man. All right? You see the prophecies turning up, man, because the Lord's like, hey, I just want the remnant to be elect. Fuck these two-thirds, man. Yeah. They ain't getting it. Alright? It wasn't meant for them.
Yeah, it says that in Ezekiel 12 chapter, man. It says that what is this proverb amongst Israel? Alright? Saying that the vision is prolonged, that it's for far off. The Lord said, fuck all that, man. I'ma have that vision, I'ma have that proverb cease. I'ma have that saying cease. Meaning what? I'ma bring, and then he further on and said, I'ma bring these visions in your day. Yeah. In this lifetime. You was talking all that shit. It's true, ain't no microchip.
Yeah.
I ain't heard that shit since.
That shit big.
Because the Lord is bringing his prophecies to pass, man. Now you niggas gotta shut up, and the prophecies is gonna speak through the prophets, man. So I'm gonna let you know what's going on. Since you niggas ain't doing it, you niggas is too busy having award shows and shit like that, man. You niggas is too busy coming up with wayward doctrines, man. Alright? While we doing our job as watchmen, what's the duty of a watchman? Ready to show up, to blow the trumpet, warn the people. Alright? That's what we do as a whole, man. And in the midst of us doing that, we also cut you niggas thick ass doctrine, man. Because we the true men of the Lord coming back on the earth today, defending the gospel, man. You know?
Yeah. Remember, we were going to that word. That word watch. You know what I mean? Basically that word watch goes into to be up while everybody's sleeping, man. That's our job, man. People out here sleep. You know?
Yeah.
But it's the Most High gave us the job. We gotta stay awake, man. We gotta keep watching. Y'all, man. We let you people know that it wake up, man. It's time to wake up now, man. You caught out there, you caught out there asleep, man. It's gonna be it for you, man.
You know, that's cause Jake, man, these niggas don't think they've done nothing wrong. You know, they just feel like they're like they are in the world, man. They're going out and have sex with a man's wife and think that shit cool, make songs about it. You know what I'm saying? Smoking blunts, thinking that shit cool. So they don't think they done nothing wrong. I got two quick precepts. This is Hosea 5:15, like what the brother mentioned. I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense and seek my face, and their affliction they will seek me early. Yep. All right, so Yahawashim Yahushua said he's going to go and turn into his place until they acknowledge what the fuck they did wrong, man. You know, and Israel is a backsliding, stiff-necked, hard-headed people, man. All right, so Yahawashim Yahushua said they got to acknowledge what they did, and that's what the men of the Lord did. We understood that the things that we were doing in the world was fucked up, man. Is Yahawashim Yahushua not worthy to be praised? All right, he deserves all the honor and the glory, but these niggas don't want to understand that. They want to glory in their idols. They want to glory in their women. They want to glory in the world, man. These niggas think everything they do is right. All right, until Yahawashim Yahushua come and send these missiles and these famines upon these motherfuckers, man. One more quick precept, my brothers and sisters. This Ezekiel 6:12. He that is far off shall die of the pestilence, and he that is near shall fall by the sword, and he that remaineth is besieged shall die by the famine. Thus will I accomplish my fury upon them. All right, Yahawashim Yahushua is going to accomplish his fury, man. And when you accomplish, that means you're going to do that shit. You're going to make it happen, man. You know, when a mission is accomplished, that means you fulfilled it to the utmost ability. All right, he's going to do everything that he said in his book.
Basically, you're on a checklist, man. Huh? You got a whole checklist. You finish one, check it off. You accomplish it, man. Mm-hmm. So you think it's too nerdy. You think it's y'all standing in the way of us getting into the kingdom. Yeah. Yahawashim Yahushua setting up a righteous kingdom where his brother's righteousness, man. Mm-hmm. So before that kingdom gets set up, it's going to start costing niggas out, man.
That's right. Yeah, letter.
Two-thirds is just a casualty of war, man.
That's it.
You got to know, man.
It's a number.
The prophet Jeremiah said, fuck it, man. Just fuck it. Just numb them to the sword. Numb them to the family, man. We got to wait on 2/3, man. The only part of letting, man, we out of here. This ain't ancient Egypt where the Lord taking everybody out. No. This is going to be niggas that stay and get this fire, man. Niggas transsexuals now, man. Bitches twerking on an abortion bed now. And posting it on social media and world stuff.
Right. You got the Church of Beyonce now.
Wow.
You got the Church of Beyonce, and you not too long ago, you had that mega orgy out there in Vegas. It's disgusting out here, man. You people show time and time again that you are worthy of judgment, man. Okay? So when brothers say you niggas gotta die, that's what it is, man. You already showed yourself to be worthy of that condemnation, man. All right? And then not only have you shown yourself to be worthy of the condemnation, the Most High has opened the doors of doors of mercy still open for you to repent, and you refuse to repent. Okay? So, yeah, you despise the word showing what? That you're prideful? Alright, that you're already condemned in the spirit of your own mind anyway, man. You don't really trust in the Lord's mercy.
on top of that, so you might as well get destroyed, man.
Book of Jeremiah, chapter 18, verse 21. Therefore, deliver up their children to the famine, and pour out their blood by the force of a sword, and let their wives be bereaved of their children.
Read up, bro.
You gotta read up.
You gotta read up. You must read up.
Verse 2.
Yeah, a couple verses. 18.
The book of Jeremiah 18, verse 18. Then said they, come, and let us devise devices against Jeremiah. So they tried to come up against Jeremiah because Jeremiah was telling the people what the Lord is saying, man.
Mm-hmm. All right. They ain't never rebuked you in the gate.
Right, man. And it says, for the law shall not perish from the priest, nor counsel from the wise, nor the word from the prophet. Come and let us smite him with the tongue. And that's our people, the majority of our people be talking that smack, man. All right? They mock us, scoff at us, but it did that to the prophets of old, man. It did it to Yahweh.
If I could just say this too, because they had an issue with Jeremiah, being set up by the Spirit of God, by Yahweh, being a prophet. It's the same thing now, where our people always say, who are you to judge me? Oh, my God, can judge me? And then they act like that's in the Bible, and then they get Tupac said that, man. You know what I'm saying? But that lets you know that our people don't want order. They don't want somebody to tell them what they can and cannot do. And it's not us. It's the spirit of the world. We're telling you directly out of the Bible, man. You know? So the same thing now, they have a problem with us having the authority through the Spirit of God, Yahweh Shem, Yahweh Shai, to tell them right from wrong, not because it's of our own, but what? The Lord has given us the spirit of discernment through these scriptures to know right from wrong, man. You know? But I just want to take that one
if I might say something very quickly, man, that's how you know it's the same niggas the Most High delivered out of Egypt. You know? Go to the mountain and tell Moses, tell the Most High to come speak to us.
Exactly.
And then when the Most High starts speaking to them, oh no, please, Moses, go talk to him. You don't want the smoke. And you see, that's exactly what's gonna happen. Alright, y'all ain't gonna wanna deal with us. Alright? The Most High's gonna come and judge y'all, and then y'all gonna be begging the Heavenly Father for some kind of mercy, man.
Yeah. Provoking him to anger, man. Y'all, man, these niggas don't know, man. These niggas don't know. But they don't wanna know. That's the part. That's why they destroy us. Scripture say my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because God has rejected knowledge, man.
It says, come and let us smite him with the tongue, and let us not give heed to any of his words. Give heed to me, O Lord, and hearken to the voice of them that contend with me. And you got people contending with us, man. It says, verse 20, shall evil be recompensed for good? For they have digged a pit for my soul, and the prophet killed us, man. Prophet killers here today, man. It says, remember that I stood before thee to speak good for them, and to turn away thy wrath from them. Therefore, deliver up your children to the famine.
Jeremiah had a change of heart, man. He said, fuck the shit, man.
Yep.
He said, remember when I was praying for these niggas? Yeah, forget all that.
And that's how it was when we first got into this truth. We were so passionate about waking up all our people, man. Right? Zealous for it, and majority of people ignored it. They said, I ain't trying to hear that. Now we're like, fuck them. Two-thirds God and God. Right? That's just what it is, man.
Yeah,
we all for it, man.
That's that hard pill to swallow.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, when you come into truth, you're like, oh, shit, we can try to get everybody on board.
Yeah.
Then you're like, shit, niggas ain't going to make it. You know what I'm saying? Shit, hey, that's the spirit of the Lord, man. These niggas deserve death, man. You know, Yahweh Shemi Awashai said, shit, you know, he's always been a man of small numbers, man. You're like, shit, so these niggas got to go. They don't understand righteousness. They want to be niggas, man. You know, so you got to do away with them, man. He said, I got to purify these people, man. You know, these niggas need that purification process, that hot fire, man.
Yeah, because when you're in this truth, you're supposed to grow. The scriptures talk about constantly abounding. You see growth in Jeremiah from the beginning of the chapter to the end of the chapter, man. At first, it was for the people. And later on, as you get more seasoned in the truth, like the apostles will tell you, you're like, man, fuck these niggas. So all these other camps that's still talking about the community and all of Israel, they didn't never get that
They're not in the spirit.
Because really, what it breaks down to, how are you going to pray for somebody that's wishing death upon you? That don't make sense. Like, you go to tell a two-third that Israelite, they're going to look at you like you got 10 heads. So why the fuck am I going to pray for you?
Bro, they want us to disappear.
Right.
They'd rather us disappear, man. Go to Mars or some shit.
Right.
Or die.
Right, bro.
Yeah, how you going to pray for someone, you know, but the Lord destined him to die?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That nigga's destined to die. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not going to pray for you. That'll piss the Lord off. And you can get jacked up.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Well, that's what Ezra's went through. Most likely. I was just going to say, that's the process that Ezra's went through as well, man. You know, the angel had to check him, like, a few times. Like, hey, man, look, don't worry about these people, man. You know, don't worry about it, man. Worry about those that are like mine, man. You know, it says, look, the multitude of parents that that were born in vain, so like you, you know? So
that's the spirit, because Brother Madaki had posted out in the comments.
I got that step on me right now. So like, real quick. This is 2 Ezra, chapter 9, verse 22. It says, let the multitude perish then which was born in vain, and let my grave be kept in my plan, for with great labor have I made it perfect.
So right. They were born in vain,
yeah.
You know, and why were they born in vain? Because the duty of man, the whole duty of man is to fear the Most High and follow his commandments. So here it is, you got Israelites, and they were supposed to be fearing the Most High and following his commandments, and they are doing it, man. So what? They were born of none avail, man. They aren't doing what they're supposed to be doing. If you go buy a car and the motherfucker don't start, then what's the point of the car? You know, you discard it, man. It's of none value, so the Lord is about to discard two-thirds of our people, man, the nation of Israel that don't want to repent.
The scriptures talk about the salt blocks the Savior, man. You know, what good is it? You know what I'm saying? These niggas ain't got the salt, man. These niggas ain't got the oil. So you're going to die. You're going to perish, man.
So I got a precept real quick. I just had this. 2 John 1 verse 9. Whosoever transgresseth and abideth not in the doctrine of Yahweh Shai has not the Most High. He that abided in the doctrine of it, Hamashiach, he has both the Father and the Son. If there come any unto you and bring not this doctrine, receive him not into your house, neither bid him Godspeed. For he that bid him Godspeed is partaker of his evil deeds. So now, we ain't praying for niggas no more, man.
That's right.
Because if we do the Lord, we'll be partaker of their deeds. We'll be partaker of being transsexuals and pimps and murderers, man. You don't wish them Godspeed. You got to get rid of them, man, because they heathens. Because what the scriptures also say, if you give them this word, basically, and they don't follow it, let them be as a heathen, man.
Yeah.
So put them to death, man. The elect got hate this place, man. Got to get up out of here, man.
Right. And there's a scripture, and I believe 1 John the 5th chapter, it says, don't pray for a man if he's done sin unto death, man. So these niggas rejected the word of Yahweh, washing Yahweh Shai, called upon other gods, saying the name of the Lord doesn't matter. Them niggas did a sin. That's a sin unto death, man. So he ain't going to pray for you, you know?
That's the worst thing that you can do. If you reject this word that's being brought forth by the men of the Lord, man, that's the worst thing that you can do.
That's right.
You
know? What's the first commandment? Thou shalt not put no other gods before the Heavenly Father. And they still doing that after being bought this truth? Oh yeah. That's they breaking the first commandment. They already off from the jump.
This is Hosea 6:5. Therefore I have hewed them by the prophets. I have slain them by the words of my mouth, and thy judgments are the light that goeth forth. You know what I'm saying? So the Lord is going to perform all these things, man. He's going to send forth the judgments. He's going to slay them by the words of his mouth, man. All right? So when Yahweh Shai sends out his word, man, that shit going to pop off, man. And them judgments going to come in. You know, Jake don't understand shit until shit hits the fan, until it's at your front door, or there's something popping off in front of you. You know what I'm saying? Your homeboy getting shot. You know what I'm saying? Something happening to your girlfriend. You know, that's when niggas start understanding what's going on, man. You know, that's why Yahweh Shai's coming back in the Isaiah 63 spirit, man. You know, he's coming back to slay the two-thirds and slay the heathens. Because these people don't want to listen, man. They don't want to hearken. The apostles been out there for decades, man. You know, and how long did it take a hard-headed nigga to... My grandfather used to say, a hard head make a soft ass, man. You know, and so that's what's going to happen to these Jake, except they soft ass is going to be a whole body full of bullets and missiles, man. You know, that's what's coming, man.
book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 23. And it shall come to pass that every soul which will not hear that prophet shall be destroyed from among the people. That's what it is, man. Alright? I'm telling you, you don't want to hear, hearken to the Lord, alright? You got a missile for that ass. Alright, you're gonna be destroyed, man. Alright? Or you're gonna have a cop shoot you 10,000 times, man. Alright? That's just what it is, man. Because you're gonna have to hearken to the prophets, alright? We the prophets, alright? We here at Great Wilson, we're the prophets. We're the apostles only down to us, man. Alright? We're telling you, bad times is coming. Alright? Get your head out of your ass. Repent. Alright? America's gonna be fucking destroyed. You see what's going on in the news, man? This shit ain't a game. If you don't want to hearken, you'll be destroyed from among the people, man.
They news is Facebook, huh?
Yep.
That's they news, shit.
Hey, niggas are atheists, man. Niggas are hypocrites, man, because they carry the Bible around and they say they believe in Jesus. But who they anyway call Jesus? Your house shall say if you see earthquakes in diverse places. Rumors of war. He said, if you see these things that's going on now, this is the time of the end. And everybody's seeing it. It's all on the news, man. They trying not to see it. They try to, you know, act like they don't see it. But man, it's before their face. That's why the Lord is gonna be the Lord is righteous and punishing them the way he's about to punish them, man. They done saw a volcano erupt, they done saw earthquakes up, they seeing Russia and all that. And when you go in the break room, when you go into work sometimes. Now you're seeing World War III all on the TV now, man. So Jake just want to ignore it. They want to ignore the words of the scriptures. They thinking they ignoring us. They ignoring the Heavenly Father because all we doing is coming out of the Bible.
I had a precept for you. Father, this is the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 6 and verse 3. And in the morning, it will be foul weather today, for the sky is red and lowering. O ye hypocrites, ye can discern the face of the sky, but can ye not discern the signs of the times?
Brother, if it look like it's about to rain, it's about you gonna say it's about to rain. It's about the storm is coming. Ooh, let's stay inside today. We can't go to the beach today. But it look like it's about to be World War III, Russia and Iran in America. It look like the dollar about to fall.
That's right.
But y'all can't discern the times, man. Wickedness is wickedness. They find a new ways to be wicked every fucking minute.
That's right.
You can't tell me at the end. All right, you just gonna be consumed with all of those that's gonna be consumed, man. That's right.
Yeah, because they were asking, it was the scribes and the Pharisees, they was asking for a sign. Now Shai's like, I'm the sign, motherfucker. I've been here, man. I've been doing the works, man. I'm in the midst of y'all. I'm fulfilling prophecy, man. You know? That's why you call them out on their bullshit. I'm gonna read again. This is Matthew 16 and 3. It says, and in the morning it will be foul weather. So you get up in the morning, you look outside, see if you need to put a hoodie on, see if you need to put Tim's on or some sneakers, whatever it may be. Alright, getting yourself ready for the day.
Sure.
It says, and in the morning it will be foul weather today, for the sky is red and lowering. O ye hypocrites, ye can discern the face of the sky, but can ye not discern the sign of the times? Right, and all the signs is here, man. Us on the highways and byways, that's the sign. Because Yahweh Shai is in the midst of us, man. You know? So that's the same sign. It's the same niggas back here on the earth, man. But you want a sign, man, you're gonna see the sign, man. You're gonna see the minute the Lord get power in the uttermost part of the earth, man. Alright, you're gonna see the UFOs, you're gonna see the so-called UFOs and chariots, man. Alright, you're gonna see all those things. And a lot of these niggas still won't believe, man. Just like they didn't believe Yahweh Shai when he was doing all the miracles, man, healing people from the dead, from the dead. They still, when he was on that cross, they still smacked him, man. They still spit on him. They still spoke down on his name after all that he done. Even afterwards, man. All right. Afterwards, they knew that he was the Son of the Most High, but through the hardness of their heart, they didn't want to believe him, man. They knew that he rose from the dead. They told everybody, "Oh, yeah, we're gonna say this. Something else happened. We're gonna say the disciples grabbed him up." You know. That's the same niggas back on this earth today. It's modern day Rome, right? It's the same Edomites that was in rulership in Rome. They're the same Edomites that's in rulership now. So the same niggas that was back then rejecting Yahweh Shai and disciples, them niggas is back here in modern day Rome, being America, man.
Hey, bro. Hey, not to cut you off, bro, but it's good to say Yahweh Shai did so many miracles. Now all the books in the world can say what he did. And then niggas still scoff. Niggas still niggas, bro. And we what do y'all shots he said? If they ain't believe me, they ain't gonna believe you. You know?
Quick read. This is 1 Thessalonians 5:1. It says, but of the time and season, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you. For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. And the reason why, because like the first scripture we brought out, you watch it, man. You know? It's plain.
That was it on that
map.
Alright, it's the book of Zechariah 7:11. But they refused to hearken and pulled away the shoulder and stopped their ears that they should not hear. And that's 2/3 of our people, man. Right, they refuse to hearken, man. You see it week in and week out, man. They walk past the camp, scoff, they don't listen. Alright, they on the comment board, scoffing. Alright, they refuse to hearken, man. Right, verse 12, it says, yea, they made their hearts an adamant stone, lest they should hear the law and the words which the Lord of hosts have sent in his spirit by the former prophets. Therefore came a great wrath from the Lord of hosts. Yeah, man, so they didn't want to hear, man. So they didn't want to hear, so the Lord's going to bring a wrath upon the ass, man. It says, yeah, they made their hearts an adamant stone. Basically, hard-headed, man. All right, it says, lest they should hear the law and the words which the Lord of hosts have sent in his spirit by the former prophets. Therefore came a great wrath from the Lord of hosts. Verse 13. Therefore it has come to pass that as he cried and they would not hear, so they cried and I would not hear, said the Lord of hosts. Yeah, man, the Lord is crying out by sending his prophets out to tell you to come back. But they're not hearing, they're not hearkening. So the Lord, he's gonna cry, he's gonna put that wrath upon you, man. Y'all gonna cry, man.
Back to what the brother said, man. These people, they're not listening to the words of the prophets, man. All right? But, you know, it was always like that, man. Our people never listen to the prophets, man. That's why we're in this predicament now. You know, the scriptures say, you know, Isaiah, was that first chapter, says, why should you be stricken anymore? The Most High is just, he did slavery, you know, he did all, you know, this and that. But this time, the scriptures say he's going to make a speedy riddance with you, man. Because right now, Most times is focused on his elect, man. And the elect are the ones crying out to get up out of this place, man. You people not sign and cry. Y'all holding us back. So the Most High is going to destroy y'all. All right? He's going to use y'all he's going to use the so-called white man to destroy y'all. Okay? He's going to deliver his elect, man. This is 2 Chronicles chapter 36. All right? In verse 14. Moreover, all the chief of the priests and the people transgressed very much. After all the abominations of the heathen, and polluted the house of Yahweh, which ye have hallowed in Jerusalem. And Yahweh, power of their fathers, sent to them by his messengers, rising up betimes and sending, because he had compassion on his people and on his dwelling place. But they mocked the messengers of the Most High and despised his words, and misused his prophets until the wrath of Yahweh arose against his people, till there was no remedy. Alright? Yeah, man, the wrath of the Most High is getting ready to come upon you people. There's gonna be no remedy for you people, man. It's 2018, alright, the year of prophecy. It's you know, brothers out here, we give you the word, man, for free. You know what I mean? Start with our apostles and elders, been doing this thing for decades, man. Alright? And you got the prophecies popping off in front of your face, man. The microchip is out. World War III is on your television screen. Okay, but you people seem like your ears and stuff, man. So yeah, there's going to be no remedy for you, man. The Most High is going to send famines, plague, death, destruction. He's going to destroy your children, as brothers are going into. He's going to destroy your wives. He's going to touch you. He's going to hit you where it hurts. You know what I mean? Ultimately, he's going to send nuclear missiles upon your head, man.
That's right.
There's not going to be no remedy for you. This is the last time. This is the last judgment. You got to pay for all your lifetimes.
Hey, the scriptures say the prayer of a righteous man avails much, right? We getting fed up. We're telling these niggas they're going to die.
Right.
That means it's getting closer, you know, because brothers praying more and more.
Blah,
blah, blah. Death to the 2/3, man. And the Most High hearing our prayer. That's why things are ratcheting up.
That's right.
That's
right.
That's what God is saying. Ancient Egypt, y'all were cries, man.
Mm-hmm.
He said the Lord heard the cries of the children of Israel. They're groaning, man. It went up to his ears and he remembered the covenant that he gave with our forefathers, man. What are the children of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, man? Those are our forefathers. That's what the covenant was made with, man. We ain't forget about us here in Egypt. You know, like you drop your child off at a fucking daycare or some shit. We ain't forget about them, man. You know they're there. there's a point in time where you gotta pick him up, man. Yep. You know, and that point in time, you approach him, man. School's gonna be up, man. All right. This place is about to be done, but this place is about to get burnt the fuck up through the scriptures. The scriptures say that, man. So that's right. Why that's they're gonna try to call us terrorists. We ain't got no fucking missiles in our backyard. We ain't got no guns in our drawer, or whatever, man. This is our weapon right here, man. All
right? Right.
This is what's bringing y'all down, and they labeling us a hate group, man. Right. Got us on these websites demonizing us, man, because we read out the Bible in which they say they believe in. All right, the God that they say that they fear, the God that they say that they trust in, we bringing out His word, and they hate us for it, man, or they demonize us for it, man. But it's all good, because Yahusha already said that would happen to His men. All right, that's showing you who His men are. We the ones catching the hell, man. We the ones out there. Let's start off with the scripture going into the watchman. And it went to Isaiah 62. The watchman will be upon thy walls, and they will never hold their peace day nor night, man. Until Jerusalem is made a praise in the earth. Clearly be not a praise in the earth, man. Brothers just was working all day, man, on their feet all day. Got to work tomorrow. Got to get up early, man. We not a fucking praise in the earth instead of offspring, which means what? We still got to continue to cry day and night. We still got to stay on our watch, man. You know?
This is dealing with Rabbi Shemuel Shah's Vince Tibet that's crying day and night. Luke 18 and 7. And shall not the power of vengeance his own elect, which cry day and night unto him, though he bear along with them, I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man comes, shall he find faith on the earth. So the Lord gonna come back and get his elect, and we starting crying daily, man. The Lord destroy this shit, man. We tired of this shit, man. We gonna come get us, man. Bapushah. The Lord hears that cry, man. Just keep on crying, and eventually he's gonna come, man. All right?
Just do your job. The scriptures say you have to work to come you have to labor to come into rest, man. Just focus on your part, which is the labor. Okay? Mm-hmm. And then, hey, the scriptures say our salvation here that we believe. Mm-hmm. You know, because when it happens, brother ain't gonna be like, well, about time. You know, hey, it's here.
Yeah.
And you're not gonna even remember how long, you know, you've been waiting for it, man. Because it's here, man. That's why the scripture says, do it, Terry, wait for it.
That's
When
a man is in prosperity, there's an emphasis in affliction.
There you go. Mm.
That's what it is.
Yeah. Mm. That's prosperity, brother.
The Lord should surely avenge himself upon this world.
That's right.
It's gonna happen. He ain't gonna sit up there. He ain't sitting up there. Oh, it's cool. You know, they are, man. They want transsexuals and homosexuals on earth. It's nothing to do what they do. No, man. Oh, I got a piece of Jeremiah chapter 9, verse 5. And they will deceive everyone his neighbor. They will not speak the truth. They have taught their tongue to speak lies and weary themselves to commit iniquity. Niggas go out, they wait to commit iniquity. They weary themselves. Like you be watching, like, ooh. God, that's niggas. That's so-called black, Latinos, and Native Americans. Spend all type of money on Christmas, man. Spend all type of money on wickedness. All type of money on, man, on just all type of drugs and killing himself, man. This is verse 6. Thine habitation is in the midst of the sea. Through the sea they refuse to know me, says the Lord Yahweh. Therefore, thus says the Lord of hosts, behold, I will melt them and try them. But how shall I do for the daughter of my people? Their tongue is as an arrow shot out and speaketh deceit. One speaketh peaceably to his neighbor with his mouth, but in heart he layeth his way. And that's niggas, because niggas hate each other. Getting on us because we bringing out the scripture saying if you don't get right, you're going to die. Y'all niggas, y'all hate it. Y'all kill each other all the fucking time. We ain't out on the streets shooting niggas and killing people. We try to bitch into the marriage. Verse 9, last verse. Shall I not visit them for these things, says the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahushan? Shall not my soul be avenged on such a nation as this? Lord, soul, man. His soul is in it now, man. So he's it's rapping to come upon you people hard, man. Niggas that don't want to hearken to this truth. As Isaiah 63, the day of vengeance is on his heart, man. It's on his mind.
And it's cool. It sounds like a broken record. We continually saying, you're going to die. Straighten up or you're going to die. But soon, you know, that record skipping is going to catch. It's going to start happening to you. You know?
That's right.
All right. And see, you know, people think, Yahweh Shah just like up in the heavens, like chilling. The Lord is thirsty to come back, man. Right. You know what I'm saying? He's waiting for his father to be like, hey, go get him. You know what I'm saying? Yahusha is ready to come back and avenge us, man.
You know, and you know, the things that he did for us, all the miracles he was working, you know, taking on our sins on that cross, man. He did so much for the children of Israel. These niggas still want to be wicked. They still want to stay in their state of folly, man. And you would think that Jake, when holidays come around, they will not want to do the shit because we say don't do it, so they can keep a couple dollars in their pocket. Yeah. These niggas are people pleasers, man. You know what I'm saying? But the Heavenly Father is no respecter of persons, man. These niggas are people pleasers. Oh, I want to make mama happy. I want to make my girl happy. Nigga, you broke as hell. You can't even pay your rent. You know what I'm saying? That's why the Lord gotta smite these people, man. And that's why he's gonna use his men to come and avenge on them. Cause we, you know, apostles are hardly like shit. I can't wait to get to these niggas, man. I'ma jump over Edomites to get to these niggas. You know? Just a quick precept, Isaiah 41:15. Behold, I will make thee a new sharp threshing instrument having teeth. Thou shalt thresh the mountains and beat them small, and shall make the hills as chaff, man. You know, so the men of the Lord are going to be turned to new instruments, man, to defeat the two-thirds and defeat the heathens, man. That's right. Why Yahweh Shai is going to put that spirit on us so that we can do that, man. And we're going to be, Lord, we're going to be those men so we can do it in righteousness, man.
It's the book of Amos 5:24. But let judgment run down as waters and righteousness as a mighty stream, man. So judgment gonna run down, man. Like he said, judgment gonna run down like the waters, man. Like, man, these niggas gonna be out here, man, getting slaughtered, man, by the spirit of power of Yahweh, my shot, man. He's gonna use his Edomites, he's gonna use his men, right? He's gonna use beasts. Man, it's gonna be like a time like never before.
And even back on that, brother brought out that Second Chronicles 36 chapter, said that the wrath of the Lord was gonna come upon him until there was no remedy. And then when you read right underneath that, it says, therefore the Lord sent the king of the Chaldees to him. Now who's the modern-day Chaldees? It's the so-called white man. So because of their wickedness, what? The Lord used these heathens to come rage on these niggas, man. And that's about to happen now, man. The scripture says that the devil's coming down having great wrath. Because you know what? That he had but a short time. It says that that he shall make war with them that have the prophecy of Yahweh Shai, man, and that keep the commandments of the Most High, man. All right, there's going to be a great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord. So that wrath is about to come down, man. But see, the scriptures talk about how all things work together for the good of them that love the Most High, man. So when we're going through these things, we're going to be preserved, and the Lord is going to be building up our spirit, purifying us, man. But when you niggas are going through it, man, it's going to be to your torment, to your destruction, man. You know?
You know why, though? Because we caught the catchphrase in there. Devil's coming down to the great wrath. I thought the transatlantic slave trade was great wrath.
Yeah,
I thought the conquistadors was great, no? Man. That's the Lord saying that. Hey, they're going to outdo that, man. They're going to make that look like Disney World.
Yeah.
That's what we took it as and said, okay, we got tied up.
Yeah,
you know?
That's right.
Two-thirds of our people are like, yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
So you got niggas saying it was a choice.
But it was a choice. You should have freaking listened.
Right.
You should have been listening to Moses and the prophets. But you chose not to listen. All right. Y'all chose to do the wickedness that y'all did, and that's why these things came upon you, man. And here it is. We're in 2018. Been out here prophesying for many, many years now, and you refuse to hearken, man. That's a choice, man.
Well, it says that in Jeremiah 8 chapter, it says, many of this evil family shall choose death rather than life, meaning that these niggas are consciously, you know, all through the spirit, are choosing death. Like, we telling them the ways of life, they're like, I ain't dealing with that. Let's go to the wide gate, you know what I'm saying? Let's take the path of wickedness, man. Let's talk about the masses. You know, what are these heathens into, man? So what? They're choosing to die, man. And if that's the way that you choose, the Lord is going to deliver that gift unto you, man. And it's going to be grievous, man. The Lord ain't going to, man, you ain't going to just go to sleep, you know, and you just wake up in the spiritual realm, man.
Nah.
The scripture says that you're going to dwell in torments, man. You got the Heavenly Father that created all things. Now he's, instead of meditating upon your good and all the things that he wants to do great for you, now he's meditating on how would it be the perfect way to jack this nigga up, to bring the greatest fears upon him, man.
It's the king of terrors. It's
all the shots, man. That's right. And the scriptures say you've been numbered to the sword already.
That's right. That's right.
That's a little insight that he got specially for you.
Yeah.
You know, what the scriptures say, you should choose your delusion. This is Romans 8:6. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace.
To be carnally minded is death, man. Choosing the ways of carnality, man, not being spiritual, you know, or just thinking about the things of the flesh and everything like that, that's death, man, you know?
Right.
the wages of sin is death, man, you know? But what? It says to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. That's why we have comfort in knowing that all these things are going to come down upon America, and we're living in America, we have peace. Because what? We got the comforter, man. You know? We got that hope. You know, we see that there's light at the end of the tunnel, man. We see that, okay, the Lord is going to bring in this judgment, but on the other side, though he's going to bring in that judgment, there's going to be salvation, but only to a specific group of people, man. That's why the scripture says, what? Put on, therefore, as the elect, all right? So what? We're doing all the things to the best of our ability. We read about what the elect are going to be doing, how they're going to be carrying themselves, man. You know, fasting, praying, watching continually, not putting down, not taking their hand off the plow. We read those things, and then we apply them, man. Putting on as the elect, you know?
And, hey, there's no need to, but we're making the Heavenly Father absolutely blameless, showing you that it can be done.
That's right.
Okay? We search after righteousness, man. Okay? And it can be done.
We listen. Right. We told you're going to get put to death if you don't stop smoking weed, if you don't stop committing adultery, if you don't stop eating pork. We listen, ain't like we just being hypocrites up here.
Right.
Scary as hell, too.
You know?
There's a barbershop, be like, don't find me up this time, man. Yeah. You know, motherfuckers trying to pass you the L.
No.
They got that lineup demon on their hands, man.
You gotta touch that motherfucker.
Yeah. Yeah. Just touch it a little bit. Right. You know, to make it look like it's not lined up. But
it's my hair.
Yeah. You show the service and they still want
to
change.
Bro, I come to you every fucking 2 weeks.
Exactly.
Bro. You know what I want.
No, you do the same shit.
Oh, yeah, yeah. They'll just, go tell a nigga in the beginning, don't touch it. It's all just clean it a little bit. Nah, I don't want none of that.
Leave it dirty, please.
We hasten for that day, Lord, destroy this place, and we look for the kingdom to come, where and dwell with righteousness, man. With everybody on the same page on the Shabbat, man. We having a maneuver over here on the Shabbat. Man, the kingdom ain't going to be all of that, man. We looking forward to getting the fuck up out this shit, man.
That's why you niggas in our way, man. And that's why we fervent about pushing this word every week. Because the more we push it, the more we push these lessons out, the closer we come to our kingdom, and the closer you niggas get crushed, man.
Right.
You know, and rightfully so, man. Because it's for you. It's for you. You know? And you don't want it. You reject it. Uh-huh. Willingly ignorant, man. Yeah. Willingly ignorant. You know, and we've heard people say, hey, yeah, that makes sense what y'all talking about, you know? Yeah. Well, like you say, just instead of going straight, you go that wagon. Yeah. You know? It looks better because it's a bunch of people over there, and I can't see.
Right.
Shit look
fun.
Right.
Strip clubs still open. And this, that still open, still holds out there. So shit, you know, niggas gonna just do their thing. You know, we man still, you know, in the mud. You know.
You know.
You know.
You know. Yeah,
and
it's just
judgment for all these things, man. You know, the Lord is gonna send his wrath, his fear upon this place, man. Well, such as that in the book of Malachi, I believe, is like pretty much alluding to it. It says, paraphrasing, you know, servants, you know, you obey them, you know, you obey your servants and you honor your father. And the Lord's like, where's my fear? Where's my honor, man? You know? So the Lord's like, he's going to send his fear upon this place, man. That's what's going to put the world in subjection unto Yahweh Yahushua. It says that at the knees of Yahushua and Mashiach, all knees will bow. That ain't going to be through political movements or nothing like that. It's going to be straight terror and dread. Like, oh, shit, I'm going to bow down because it's some destruction coming to my ass if I don't. Now, we, through the spirit of Yahweh Yahushua, we see, we understand the fear of the Lord, man. You know, we fear like, damn, this is what the Lord can do to me. If not, it's going to take these niggas when the Lord starts bringing that belt out and whooping your ass. And then it's like, all right, now I'm not going to, I don't want to do that anymore. Because now I feel that judgment, you know. But it's going to come, you know.
Hey, but it's a gift, man, because it's a fear, you know, a power that you can't tangibly touch or see, you know. And that's a gift, man. You know, when you come to the realization that the majority of our people, they're atheists. They don't believe in God. They really don't.
Right.
That's why when you bring these scriptures out, you're the worst person on the face of God. Because, hey, Yahusha say, hey, blessed is he who's not offended in God.
Right.
This book is very offensive, especially to a people that have been away from the heritage for so long, the law, statutes, and commandments.
Especially to a demon, man.
Exactly.
Bring out this truth. It says that with Solomon, the second chapter, it talks about the mindset of the wicked, and they was thinking about us. You know, they said his ways is clean contrary to our ways, man. So this book is completely opposite on how these niggas want to live their life. They want to do the bullshit. Like, I talked to the nigga Adrian Broder. I'm telling this nigga, yeah, Israel, like, I'm in Miami. Meaning what? I'm not worried about that. I'm worried about these Miami bitches, man. I'm worried about this Miami pussy out here, man. He don't give a damn who he is. Don't have a clue where he's from. Because he's in Miami.
This is Psalms 119 and 155. Salvation is far from the wicked, for they seek not thy statutes, man. Like, it's the niggas, man. That's plain, man. Salvation is far from the wicked, man. Yeah. 2/3 of our people are considered the wicked, man, because they just like their father Esau, man.
He said what? Because they seek not his statutes, man. Going back to what? You got to seek Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. He's going to come looking for your ass, man. He's on his throne. You got to go to the king, man.
Right. And the nigga attitude, if God was to come to them, he got to come right with them, you know? That's how niggas think.
Yeah.
You got to be the way they want you.
Right.
Else they going to still keep doing what they doing.
Right. Yeah, that's the spirit, man. Because he talks about how they refuse to conform to the Most High's righteousness and want to establish their own righteousness, man.
Yeah.
That's why they don't like what we come out with, man. Because you got to change your ways. When you serve in Jesus Christ, right? Hey, you can be whatever you want, man. You can do whatever you want. You just got to pray one time. Cool. You go commit adultery. Oh, I'm sorry. And then that's it. You know what I'm saying? Say your prayer, you're all good. But now, when you serve in the true power of the Bible, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, you got to come correct unto him, man. Lord ain't Santa Claus. He ain't doing whatever you want him to do. You never pray. Niggas think the Lord has to save him, man. Like the Lord got to save your ass. Like, nah, he ain't got to save you, bro. You can sit there and die. And the Lord ain't going to blink an eye. As a matter of fact, not only will he not blink, you don't laugh. Right.
The first chapter,
man.
And the kicker is, his ways are not grievous. We all live in testimonies of it. It's not grievous. Actually, we love to do righteousness, man, like the scriptures say.
Yeah.
We rejoice in righteousness, man. This, you see the product of striving for righteousness right here in your face.
We like women. We go to a strip club, you know. Just don't commit adultery. She got a man, don't fuck with her. Stop fucking eating pork. Niggas like chicken, eat chicken, turkey, fish. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Seek the Lord. You be on Instagram all day, every day. read some scriptures.
Listen, I'm gonna read a couple scriptures a year.
Bruh, they don't touch the Bible no more. Niggas don't touch the Bible no more.
Only on Easter Sunday and Christmas Sunday.
And they still ain't touching the Bible.
Oh, no, they read the hymns, though.
Or John 3:16.
That's all they go to church for, the fucking choir.
Hey, brother, run the precept.
Yeah,
yes. Wrap it up.
Yeah.
I got this one. This is 2 Ezra chapter 15 and verse 24. Woe to them that sin and keep not my commandments, said the Lord. I will not spare them. Go your way, ye children, from the power. Defile not my sanctuary. So the Lord ain't going to spare you niggas, man. You've been told time after time again, man. The scripture says if the Lord had not come unto you, you would have no sin. But what this gospel has been preached throughout all the corners of the earth, and the end is coming, man. So there's no hope for your sins, all right? It says, I will not spare them. Go your way, ye children, from the power. Defile not my sanctuary. For the Lord knoweth all them that sin against him, and therefore delivereth he them unto death and destruction. So the Lord is going to deliver you to death and destruction. That's his mindset for you, man. All right, you rejecting the Lord, it's like, all right, cool. You brushing me off, I'm going to brush your ass off, man. It says, verse 27, for now are the plagues come upon the whole earth. So now it's that time of judgment, you know. Now it's the time, the doors of repentance are open right now. All right, the missiles ain't flying yet. You know, martial law troops ain't banging down the doors yet, but we see it's here, you know. But it says what? For now are the plagues come upon the whole earth, and ye shall remain in them. For the Most High shall not deliver you because ye have sinned against him. So the Lord ain't going to deliver you, man. You know, you taking the Lord for a joke, like this is a game, you just talking shit on the video. What's these niggas talking about, you know? Nah, man, the Lord ain't going to deliver you, man. And that's going to be a scary, horrific time. And it's going to be set up that way to your...
tailored to your specific fears, man, because the Lord is going to make you bow down unto him, man.
Right. That's right. That's it. I got a quick precept. It speaks for itself, real talk. This is Judges 10 and 14. Go and cry unto the gods which ye have chosen. Let them deliver you in the time of your tribulation. Hey, go to them, man. You know, because you ain't calling on your house by Shani Al-Shad. Your ass going to be sitting there stuck talking about arise and save us, man. And they not going to deliver you, man. So that's all I got for us.
It's based on his brothers that's continuing, man. The Lord, he called us in his truth for salvation. But the other ones, man, he going to give the wrath of God. This is 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 9. For Yahweh have not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Yahweh Shah, by Mashiach. Man. So the Lord, you have the men that's pushing this truth. Hey, this wrath is not for us. No one will be a part of that flesh, man. It's for you damn wicked. 2/3 and you beat this, man. Right?
Well, validates that. That's why we can boldly go out there and proclaim. You know, we don't know. You know, we gotta do this to the end. You know, but the reason we can boldly proclaim it is because we got a shot, man. So, not giving us the wrath, man. You know? We ain't go out there and say, yeah, I'm giving the wrath. No. We expect hope to be saved.
Yeah, you know? Man, be fully persuaded in his mind. You gotta keep going. That's keep going.
Yeah, I was just pulling out Proverbs, you know, the other young call always posting in Proverbs, man. It says the expectation of the wicked is wrath.
Right,
you know?
Right.
So that's why these niggas really get shook up on the sense, you know what I'm saying? Because they spirit, they knowing they ain't gonna try and perform into the ways of Yahweh Shemayah Shah. So they know only wrath is coming to them, man. But what we have the godly fear is like, man, that fear strikes in us to do his will, to be obedient, man. But these niggas don't want to repent. So what? They know that they're gonna have to catch that wrath in the spirit.
Because what it boils down to, way deep down, we got a chance. We know that we have a chance. Way deep down, they know that they don't have a chance. It's just that they can't tie their flesh to their spirit, so they can't, you know, they can't forget.
Hebrews chapter 10, and verse 28 says, he that despised Moses is God, God without mercy on the two or three witnesses. Of how much more sore punishment, suppose he, shall he be thought worthy who hath trodden under the foot of some of the Most High, who hath counted the blood of the covenant, or if he was sanctified an unholy thing, and at the despite unto the spirit of grace, man, that's our people, man. Our people do not want to hearken to the spirit of Yahweh that was shot, man, which is the spirit of grace, man. Moses' law, all right, because we're in the flesh, it condemns everybody to death, man. But through Yahweh Shai, grace has been opened up to the nation of Israel, man. All right, and in order for that spirit of grace to be given and this and dispensed to the Lord's people, Yahweh Shai had to die on the cross for the sins of the nation of Israel, man. Okay? So if you despise the word and you despise the spirit of Yahweh Hashem El Shai, you reject the word of Yahweh Hashem El Shai, you ought to be destroyed, man.
Sure.
Okay? Verse 30, it says, for we know him that hath said, vengeance belongeth unto me. I will recompense, saith the Lord, and again the Lord shall judge his people. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living power, man. All right? That's the message, man. All right? If you don't repent, you're going to fall into the hands of the living power, and he will teach you to fear him, man. He gonna make you a believer in the worst way.
That's right. They should know it after death by pain.
You got it?
Listen, man, what you said, I wasn't gonna bring it up, but what he said in Psalms chapter 1, verse 11, serve Yahweh with fear and rejoice when trembling. Psalms 2, Salaki. Psalms 2. And verse 11, serve Yahweh with fear, rejoice with trembling. Kiss the Son, lest he be angry, and he perish from the way. When his wrath is kindled but a little. Blessed are all they that put their trust in him. You know, like everybody said, man, the Son of the Heavenly Father, man, is coming back, man. He's coming back with a lot of wrath, man, and great fury, man. You know? That's all I gotta say.
Psalms 11 and 6. Upon the wicked he shall rain snares, fire, and brimstone, and a horrible tempest. This shall be the portion of their cup.
It's a definite destruction if you 2/3 ass niggas, and that's just your portion.
That's right. That's right. That's what you want, brother. What you asking for? You asking for salvation. You asking for death. Why do you love death?
give all praises, honor, and glory to
Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Rakak, Kadash.
And double honors to the elder apostle, the great millstone, the tight distance to all the Akim out there, pushing the word of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, in truth and in sincerity. Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Rakak, Kadash, Rakatan. With that, we want to say Shalom.
Shalom.